Hello players, my name is Andy, I'm the creator of Event Horizon Gaming, and today we are playing Watcher of Realms. Specifically, we're going to do gear rate 1 level 20 without any actual DPS, so let's get started. So, as you can see here, we have only healers and defenders, with the exception of Aeon or Eon, that she's going to be only used for her Lord bonus. So, let's get started with the actual highlights of this lineup, which is going to be Artemis and REVE or REVE. So, Artemis is in an Infernal Roar set, nothing too crazy, not even crit capped. He is in a mediocre build, if I am to say so. Not too great, not too bad, but it's gonna do the job. REVE is going to be actually surprisingly the highlight of this and the main damage dealer of this lineup, and he's going to be in an Soulbound Arcana set. Again, nothing too crazy, like the crit damage is definitely a little bit low. The attack speed is decent, but definitely a lot squishier than a normal tanking build. Like, look at this, only how much HP? Only 51,000 HP in total, so he's going to be very squishy. I actually forgot to mention, and I actually remembered while recording this video, is the fact that REVE has his exclusive artifact, and this is also some kind of exclusive artifact showcase for Captain REVE, and Mr. Artemis over here has a golden scarab, but neither of these two are very leveled up. Like, it's very hard to level up exclusive artifacts over plus 10 already anyway, but mine is plus 10 as well, and the golden scarab is, to be honest, only plus 13, nothing too crazy. So yeah, let's switch back to the actual fight. So the other guys are going to be Hollow, used for rage regen and healing. She's in an invigoration set, nothing too crazy, focused on attack speed and attack. Then a Laurel, again just for cost generation, rage regeneration, another invigoration set. Then Dolores. Everyone knows what Dolores does and why we're using her. Focused on attack. She has 12 point something K attack. Then Elowin. Elowin is supposed to be used for her passive that provides some more rage regen and some more healing. Also, her elf is very important because it's going to help REVE survive. And Cyrus, which is going to be placed on the left side, but he isn't in insane gear, he's just there to cover a left side that isn't actually covered and provide some extra soaking for the health bar of the big wall that we're trying to protect. So let's get started with how I do this fight. As you can see, Power of Dominance is turned off, so let's go. So we want to place REVE here. And then we'll place Artemis, and then Miss Dolores right in between. The reason we do that is because right here in between all three of them, we're gonna place Laurel so their ults regenerate faster. But the next one in the lineup is going to be Hollow, and we're gonna be placing Hollow right here at the bottom right hand side, because that's going to allow Elowin to heal everyone as well. And then we're gonna be using Laurel, and keep an eye on Hollow's ultimate, because as soon as that's ready, we're gonna be ulting with everyone. So the order is going to be Artemis, REVE, Dolores, Hollow. Then we pick up Laurel, place down Elowin, and we will ult again with everyone, and as soon as that's ready we ult with Hollow, Now, this is the first tricky side. We forgot to place down Cyrus, but it's okay, no problem. Because you want to keep alive Reeve, and these guys, they do a lot of damage, they dish out a lot of damage. So we use the ultimate as soon as Artemis is also ready. We place down the elves to keep him alive. We use Artemis, Reeve, and Dolores. We place down Laurel. We pick her up. And we use Hollow. And we ult Cyrus to soak. Wall HP. And we use Elowin to help out with the healing for Captain Reeve. And we are just about ready to ult again as soon as these guys come back up. So we ult again. It's Hollow to help out with the regen again. And Mr. Cyrus. Nice. So we are gonna ult one more time with everyone. This stage is of the game is very, very hard because everyone's gonna deal a lot of damage on Reeve. But I think we can do it. And we place Laurel down. And we wanna keep an eye on Reeve because he's gonna die fairly easily if we are not being careful enough. So right as Elwin's ult is finishing, we place down Reeve. Oh, it's died there. It's rough and hard. We use again Miss Elwin right in time. And Artemis to help out with the remaining mongrels. Hollow, Cyrus. And if we've done everything right, that should be a race of time. But it's cutting it close. We're gonna ult with Elwin just in case again. Gonna ult with Mr. Reeve again because he's our main DPS, surprisingly, right? We are placing Laurel down, picking her back up. Also, the exclusive artifacts helps a lot. I think I forgot to mention that. Ult with Elowin, ult with Cyrus, and that's nice. Activate Artemis as quickly as possible. Dolores, and we don't even need the elf anymore. Hollow for rage regen, Cyrus to soak up damage. And as I said, now this has become just a race against time. So we're gonna wait for Artemis's ult to charge up back again before we use Reeve and everyone else like before. Placing Laurel down. Reeve, Artemis, Dolores, Hollow. We'll pick up Laurel. We use Cyrus because he's gonna have some more attack speed when he uses ultimate, even if he doesn't place down the actual skeleton. Maybe even Elowin, even though we don't need Elowin at this point, just for the rage regen. Follow the cycle one more time. And that this cycle should be the one that kills the mobs, yeah. And now we are focusing on the actual boss. And I think we should be able to clear the boss exactly when the wall falls. Bam, bam, bam. Laurel, pick Laurel back up. And come on, we can do this, come on. Nice, nice. Be able to pull soon enough again. Come on, Mr. Reeve. Come on, Mr. Artemis. Dolores. Hello. Reeve is gonna get one shot. There we go. I knew that. And I think we should have Laurel just in time to hit for the remaining percentage, right? So let's see. Laurel. Activate Dolores right about now. And we are ready with this little elf to help out with. There we go. And this is it. So cutting it very close, but we managed to deal to do this without an actual DPS. So how cool is that, right? Now that we have heroes that are so complex and diverse that we can actually do stuff like this. So this is why I love this type of games, because you can get towards late game content, because you can call gear raid 120 late game, kind of late game, like the beginning of late game, right? You can clear late game content with stuff like this, with creative stuff like this. So again, what I failed to mention at the beginning is the fact that Reeve actually has his exclusive artifact that's going to provide some more help. But what I failed to show you was the actual damage. So let me do the run one more time so I can actually show you the damage outputs and let you be surprised. So look at that. Reeve with almost 100k damage, right? 100k damage. And that could be considered on par with some S plus mages, right? So with a mediocre build and his exclusive artifact, Reeve has been able to deal quite a bit of damage, and also Artemis. Keep in mind that also both of these guys aren't in optimal builds. As I said, Reeve is in some different builds than usual. So yeah, I'm quite satisfied with how this turned out. Running over the itemization of my lineup really quickly again, and over the artifacts of the main DPS. So Mr. Artemis in an Infernal Roar set that's considered to be mediocre, not the set itself, but the stats provided by my set specifically is mediocre. As you can see, only 59,000 BP. His artifact is a Golden Scarab. That's only plus 13, so nothing too crazy. And Reeve, the only interesting stuff about him that made him a good DPS and actual main damage dealer is the fact that I used the exclusive artifact, the Anchor of the Damned, and it really made a difference, right? So besides that, I am in a Soulbound Arcana set. Again, nothing too crazy, because as you can see, he's very squishy, like only 51,000 HP in total, and almost crit capped, but with so little crit damage. And the attack is quite good in itself, but yeah, again, this is pretty cool because we can do stuff like this. And I'm going to try Reeve in his exclusive artifact in some different content so that I can actually showcase his artifact a little better. But this was a little nice preview of what we can do with Reeve and in conjunction with ARTEMIS if we play them right. So this was stage 20 from gear rate 1 without an actual DPS. So pretty cool, right? Let me know if you find this entertaining, if you what do you think about this strategy and the way I did it with only a defender and a healer as my main damage dealers. And don't forget to like, to subscribe, to comment. I read every single comment that I see. This has been Andy, Event Horizon Gaming, wishing you an amazing week. See you guys. Bye bye.